So today I'm giving a talk about a small part of my research topic, namely a capacitive, low-cost capacitive sensor readout. I want to start right away with the motivation. The idea was that we build a low-cost sensor for medical, pharmaceutical, and life science applications like drug delivery, microdosing, or monitoring of dispensing. The idea was to have a disposable sensor which is low-cost, so to avoid cross-contamination. And to keep it low cost, the sensor consists of a disposable measuring cell produced in a two-component injection molding process done by a colleague of mine, Sabrina Kartmann. And this measuring cell is then entered in a housing. Here you see the prototype housing, also used for the measurements later. And this housing, including the electronics, is reusable. So we only have this very low cost disposable part here. In our work we're going to present right now, we use a differential measurement setup which is feasible to detect failure like occlusion, airlocks, or crossflow in multi-effusion systems. Now I just want to give a short overview how the measurement cell works. So the measuring cell consists of an expandable tube. And this tube is connected to the fluidic path. So if the inner pressure is equal to the outer pressure P out, so the ambient pressure, then we have just a base capacitance C0. And if now the inner pressure increases, the fluidic, the dielectricum in between the electrodes changes, and therefore we detect a capacitive change. And this simple setup can also be used to monitor flow during flow measurements. So we use two of these measuring cells interconnected by a capillary with a known fluidic resistance RF. And by measuring the pressure drop across this capillary, we can conclude to the overall volume flow. So now I want to show how the readout itself was conducted. So we have here the capacitor, the sense capacitors in some kind of a capacitive bridge configuration. So we apply a modulation voltage to these capacitors, and we detect the charge flowing out of the sensor element. This modulation voltage is about 50 kilohertz in order to use charge chopping. This means we suppress flicker noise of the amplifier. The charge we detect is proportional to, so it's amplified by the modulation voltage, it's proportional to the base capacitance. If the pressure is zero, plus a capacitive change. And this readout circuit only detects the difference between these capacitance flowing from CS1 and CS2. So therefore, we have an output voltage, which is just the difference of the capacitive change of both sensors. The good thing by this measurement setup is that we can suppress common mode signals like changes in ambient pressure or humidity. We use these two capacitors C0 in order to stabilize the input common mode of this amplifier and to account for mismatches in the base capacitances of these two measuring cells. A mismatch in this base capacitance would result in an offset at the end of our readout chain. Therefore, we have the opportunity by scaling the voltage amplitude of one of these counter pulses in order to suppress offsets. So I just want to go through the complete signal processing chain here by simulation results. So we have here our bridge configuration with this charge-to-voltage converter. We apply a flow rate to the input of the sensor element. It consists of a DC part and sinusoidal signal superimposed. At the output of the charge-to-voltage converter, we see, if we zoom to this signal, we see that the output signal is modulated onto the carrier frequency of 50 kilohertz. Then we amplify it in a further stage and high-pass filter before we apply it to a demodulating stage, which is just based on switches. Since we use a rectangular modulation voltage, this is feasible. And back in the baseband, you still see modulation artifacts, which are removed by a second-order low-pass filter, so that in the end we have a signal proportional to the capacitive change at the input. Now I want to show some measurement results of the system. We're using a pre-CP prototype, which consists of all the stages we have seen before. The sensor element is shown here. This is this prototype sensor element with this 3D printed housing. The modulation voltage was chosen to be plus minus 2 volts within the 5 volt supply of the CB converter. And the overall noise of the readout circuit corresponds to 320 microvolt over 500 hertz or 40 autofarad resolution. Now I show some measurement results for pressure as well for flow measurements. During pressure measurement, we used a pressure regulator in order to capture the characteristic curve of the sensor element. The upper full scale of 100 kilopascal is limited by the stability of the measuring cell. We repeated this measurement 5 times, and since the sensor element itself has a nonlinear characteristic with the applied pressure, we linearized with a second order polynomial fit. And this results in these measurement specs right here. So we have a resolution better than 200 Pascal, a nonlinearity of 1.4% full scale, and the overall accuracy is limited by the hysteresis of the measuring cell. Now I also want to show some measurement results for flow measurement setup. Here we're using a syringe pump in order to generate the flow. We have a reference sensor just to get the real value for the measurement for our calibration curve. The characteristic curve was measured up to 50 microliters per second. And we see also here that the crosses are the measured values. And we see that the second order fit in this measurement setup is not sufficient for some applications, since we have a full scale, as a nonlinearity of 7.8% full scale. So by using a third order fit, we can reuse this by a factor of 4. The overall resolution is about 117 nanoliters per second during this measurement. Also want to show some step response plots. So you see here the data of the reference sensor over time and the output voltage. This output voltage for second order or third order fit, and we see for the second order fit, the blue graph, this nonlinearity overestimates the flow in low flow rate flow ranges. So as a conclusion, I have shown a differential readout concept for capacitive pressure and flow sensors. The readout electronic was simulated and implemented for validation on a PCB prototype. The measurement range is 0 to 100 kilopascal or 5 microliter per second during flow setup, and it's limited by the cell stability itself. The resolution is about 40 autofarad over a bandwidth of 500 hertz, which corresponds to 200 pascal or 170 nanoliters per second. As an outlook, there's some work to do. First, we have seen that with the calibration curves during flow measurement, we have to see if a batch calibration is possible. So therefore, we need a higher amount of measuring cells and a lot of measurement data to see if we can use only calibrate some of this, get the calibration curve only from some of the sensors and use this for complete batch. There's further development on the sensor side is going on regarding hysteresis and linearity. So different materials are validated right now. We have to keep in mind that these materials are also the sensor cell was used by a 2-in-2 material injection molding process, so the material itself has to be compatible to this injection molding process. And in the future, we can also think about an ASIC implementation of the readout circuit so that we can place the electronics directly in the housing of the sensor near the electrodes. So thank you very much for your attention. I'm open for any further questions.